In our bakery, there are only a few problems and also the number of influences is small. Nevertheless, we have not been able to measure data for all hypotheses because this would have been very time-consuming. In our project, we could now immediately get into the root cause analysis and link statistical results with expert assumptions. Nevertheless, I would like to prioritize the problems first to better organize the further procedure. We are committed to solving all the problems of the project charter and to achieving the related targets. And a separate root cause analysis must be created for each problem. Especially in complex projects, it can be efficient to prioritize the problems for their analysis. The basic prioritization criterion is the severity of the problems we identified in the define phase. Now I would like to additionally distinguish between problems of different categories and problems within the same category. According to a well-known lean principle, quality problems have the highest priority, because it makes no sense to make an error faster. Typically, a quality problem leads to a reduction in availability. If an order is incomplete, we need to clarify it with the customer. And this clarification increases the cycle time and the resource consumption. Solving the quality problem would thus increase the availability and decrease the consumption of human resources. The same applies to all other error corrections. These problems are therefore interdependent. However, solving the quality problem alone does not lead to a complete solution of the availability or resource problem. Availability problems often result from the sum of many small delays in several activities, while quality problems are often triggered by exactly one activity. Relationships between problems can be well discovered with plausibility considerations and confirmed with the correlation or regression analysis. This also applies to dependencies within a category. The Pareto chart is suitable to prioritize the problems based on their frequency or based on the resulting quality costs. I collected data to the quality problems cookie taste bad, cookie weight wrong, cookie diameter wrong, ingredients weight wrong, cookies broken, cookies burned, and ingredients expiry date exceeded. The Pareto chart is suitable for nominal scale data, for example OK versus defect. To transform the ordinally scaled rating data to the lower nominal scale level, I assigned the ratings above our specification limit 4 to the category OK and the bad ratings 5 and 6 to the category defect. Of course, this also works for cardinally scaled data. This way you can display and prioritize all problems in a Pareto chart. The left Pareto chart prioritizes the defects according to their frequency and the right according to the resulting quality costs. Our problem with the highest severity, cookie taste bad, is in first place in both charts. But there are a few shifts in the lower rankings. And you can choose the criterion, frequency or cost, according to which you work through the ranking. However, this only applies if the problems are independent. In the case of dependent problems, the most frequent problem often occurs at the end of the process chain. If, for example, the amount of ingredients is too small, then the probability increases that the cookies will be shaped smaller to keep the total number constant and that the required weight of the cookies will then not be correct. In addition, there may be further influences leading to cookies being too small and their weight deviating. The problem of ingredient amount too small then receives a subordinate place in the Pareto chart, but should be solved with higher priority. The solution of the ingredients problem will probably reduce the problem of the cookie diameter and the problem of the cookie weight. To uncover these dependencies, you can first create a hierarchy tree just for showing the dependencies between problems, based on observations and logical assumptions, and if possible, confirmed by means of correlation or regression. And of course, you can additionally prioritize problems by differentiating them with a t-test, as we did it with the ratings for vanilla versus chocolate cookies, and with the ANOVA to compare more than two products or services. Once you have prioritized the problems, you can prepare the result, for example the Pareto charts and the hierarchy tree, on a flip chart for your root cause analysis workshop to discuss it with the experts.